That's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind.
Sorry that this unboxing took a little bit to get here because, well, clearly I had to go to the moon to actually get the phone itself. And, you know, those suits aren't the nicest to walk in and then, you know, unbox itself. So I kind of had to get back to Earth and then get it again. Anyway, let's talk about the phone itself and, of course, the specifications in terms of what you get inside of the box as well. Now, of course, this is the OnePlus 9 and not the OnePlus 9 Pro. While I think the OnePlus 9 Pro is a really compelling package, I think this one might be more suited to those who really want a compelling package for a little bit less. The OnePlus 9 comes with a lot of specifications that you will find on the OnePlus 9 Pro as well. This one, for instance, still features the same dual camera setup and, of course, the third one that really doesn't matter that much. But anyway, the main ones: the 48 megapixel wide sensor with a 1/143 in sensor size, and then of course your ultra wide that now actually has a large sensor as well, something that a lot of companies don't do at the moment. But it's a 50 megapixel ultra wide sensor with a 1/156 inch sensor size, so it's pretty close in terms of size when it comes to that sensor as well. Of course, you have video capabilities up to 8K and 30 frames per second, but honestly, I wouldn't use 8K. But next to that, you do have your 4K, 30 frames per second, and 60 frames per second, and then you have your 1080p and, of course, some options there as well. And then, of course, you have the latest CPU. It's the Snapdragon 888. It has a 5G chip and, of course, 8 or 12 gigabytes of RAM. In terms of internal memory, you either have 128 gigabytes or 256 gigabytes. You cannot expand it via the microSD though. It comes with UFS 3.1 in terms of storage speed. For the battery, you get a 4500 mAh battery, and of course you get a charger inside of your box that charges up at 65 watts, which means about 29 minutes to 100%. But this is what is advertised, so I will check it out how that actually works and if it actually delivers that much power in such a short amount of time. In terms of display, you get a 120Hz 6.55 inch display with a full HD plus resolution, and the max brightness is 1100 nits. Now, that's a bit lower than some other offerings, of course, that get to 1500 or some even to 1700, but that's fine for me. But anyway, I'm really curious to see what OnePlus has done here and, of course, the collaboration with Hasselblad. I care a lot about my images, and if you haven't noticed, in my reviews, I often tend to focus a little bit more on images themselves because that's one of the key features for me. Of course, what is also a key feature for me is sadly a 3.5mm headphone jack that this phone doesn't offer, neither a microSD, so do keep that in mind when you look at a phone like this. Those things, those basic things, aren't covered, but at least you get a charger inside, which is sadly now a feature. Anyway, what do you think about the OnePlus 9? Let me know in the comments below. And of course, if you did enjoy this video that took me way too long to make and it makes no sense why I did this, don't forget to leave a like and, of course, subscribe and hit the bell icon if you want to see more things like this. Anyway, I do hope that you enjoyed this little experience. And if you did, good, because I'm glad to hear that. Either way, have a good one and talk to you guys in the next one.